welcome to the course on strength of material, and also we call it as mechanics of materials or strength of materials and solids and structures. So in this lecture we are going to discuss about the introduction of strength of material. So first of all, there is one word which is strength. So strength is defined as a capability of material, but here in this subject we'll define the strength in terms of stress. So first of all, we can say strength is defined with a term which is stress, or we can say strength is a maximum value of stress which a material can sustain, or we can say a maximum value of stress with which a material can withstand without failure. So this is how we can define the strength of material, right? So here we'll talk about the stress first. So stress is, this is internal resistance provided by a material when it is acted upon by a external force. So stress is the internal, or we can say the intensity of internal resistance provided by the material when it is acted upon by external force. What does it mean? Like, we are having a object, and if we are applying a external force over it, this is pull force, you can say tensile force, then there would be internal resistance. If I want to draw the free body diagram and I want to cut this material at this point, so this will look like something. So this will look like there is an internal resistance provided by this material against its deformation. So if this small arrow is represented by small f, this is f, then we can say this sigma f is equal to f, and intensity of this sigma f per unit area, if we divide this sigma f by cross-sectional area of this element, then this is known as stress. So stress can be defined as the intensity of internal resistance per unit area provided by the material when it is subjected to a external load. Now we'll talk about the one more term in this subject, which is strain. So strain is change in the dimension. This is the ratio of change in dimension to the original dimension. So this is strain. So the ratio of change in dimension to the original dimension, this is strain. Like if we are talking about the dimension, that dimension can be length, can be its diameter, or we can say change in shape. So we can say to recognize the change in dimension or deformation, we must know about the original dimension. So if we are taking the ratio of change in the dimension to the original dimension, then that quantity is defined as strain, and it's a dimensionless quantity. Next, when we are applying a force, stresses will be induced. And there is a maximum stress, which is a property of material. And, or we can say strength of material, if up to if we are applying the stresses more than this maximum stress, then this material will get failed. So here word is failure. How we will define the failure? So we can say failure of the object or material can be defined as if any object does not meet the criterion defined by the designer, then this object will be considered as failed object. So talk about the so on the based of those criteria we can talk about the failure of modes of failure. So first mode of failure can be a plastic deformation, or we can say the permanent deformation. So if the object is subjected to external force and if it will deformed permanently, then this object will considered as a failed object. Or second can be a fracture. So if the object is subjected to external force and it will get fractured or it will break down permanently, so this will get considered as failed component. And third can be if induced stresses exceeds the permissible stress, then also component will considered as a failed component. Or we can say if the deformation is more than the permissible deformation, like if we are having a beam and you are applying a load over this beam and it will get deformed like this. So if this deflection of the beam is more than the permissible deflection, then this component will also considered as a failed component. So one component can be failed in three ways. One, if there is yielding or plastic deformation, the component will considered as a failed component. Second, it will can break, then it will be failed component. And third, if the stresses or deflection or deformation exceeds the permissible value of stress or deflection, then this component will also get considered as a failed components. So in this subject, next we'll talk about the forces or load. So next is forces. So here we'll talk about the types of forces. So here we'll talk about the types of force. So first can be of mechanical force. Second can be of electromagnetic force and gravitational force. So here this electromagnetic or gravitational force can be applied on the component without any direct contact. So here this type of force is known as non-contact force. And mechanical force needs a direct contact or physical contact with the component when we are applying a force on the component, like if we are having a component and we want to elongate this, we have to apply the force with direct contact with the component, then this type of force is known as mechanical force. Now we'll define the strength of material. So here the strength of material is a branch of mechanics, right? So now the mechanics, what is the mechanics? So mechanics is a branch of science where we'll study about the force and energy and their effect on various objects. So this is how we can define the mechanics. Mechanics is a branch of science where we are studying about the forces and energy and effect of force and energy on various components. So within this mechanics, there is engineering mechanics, so in the engineering mechanics we are study the effect of force and energy on the rigid bodies. So now the rigid body is when we are applying the external force over it, it will not get deformed, or we can say the distance between the two point on the object when we are applying the external force, though that force can be of any type. So distance between these two points will be unaltered. So this type of body is known as rigid body, or we can say this is a hypothetical body, because in reality there is no component which will not get deformed on the application of objects. But in the rigid body, regardless of the applied force, this will not get deformed. So we can say this is a hypothetical body. So second branch of the mechanics is strength of material. So here we are talking about the deformable bodies. Or we can say in the strength of material we are going to study the forces and energy and effect of force and energy on the deformable bodies, and we'll talk about the deformation. And third branch of the mechanics can be a fluid mechanics. So in this we are talking about the forces and energy and their effect on the fluid. So now we can define the fluid as, so fluid is a substance which deforms continuously in the direction of force. So this is how we can categorize this mechanics. So first can be of engineering mechanics or classical mechanics, where we are talking about the forces and energy and their effect on the rigid body, which is hypothetical body. And in the strength of material, we are talking about the forces and energy and their effect on the deformable bodies, or also called as real body, and also we can call it is a resistant body. And third branch of mechanics can be a fluid mechanics, where we are talking about the forces and energy and their effect on the fluid. And fluid can be defined as a substance which deforms continuously in the direction of object, or we can say even when we remove the forces, the fluid will not regain its original shape, or you can say the fluid is not having any memory. So in the strength of material, we are talking about the two type of deformation. One is elastic deformation and one is of plastic deformation. So here in this subject, we'll talk about the elastic deformation. So this is, here we'll study about the theory of elasticity. And here we'll study about the theory of elasticity. So in this subject we'll focus on the theory of elasticity or elastic deformation. So within this we can say when we deform the object, deform the object with the application of external force within a limit in which on the removal of external load it will or object will regain its original shape. So that limit is known as elastic limit. So in this subject we'll talk about the elastic deformation or theory of elasticity. And in the plastic deformation, the deformation is permanent, or we can say on the removal of external loads, it will not regain its original shape, and the deformation is permanent. So we'll focus on the theory of elasticity only. So the first module of this subject will be on simple stress and strain. So here in the first module we'll talk about the simple stress and strain, and we'll talk about the types of elastic modulus, relationship between elastic modulus. We'll talk about the statically indeterminate structures. We'll talk about the series or parallel combination of structure or components. We'll talk about the factor of safety. We'll talk about the thermal stresses. And in the second module of this subject, we'll talk about the principal stresses or complex state of stress. Here we'll talk about the principal planes, plane of maximum shear stress and we'll talk about the stresses on inclined planes, and at the end, most important, we'll discuss the graphical representation of these stresses, which is called as Mohr's stress circle. In the third module, we'll talk about the bending of beams, or we'll study about the bending of beams. So here we'll talk about the shear force and bending moment diagrams. We'll talk about the point of contraflexure. And will consider the various boundary conditions of beams and will draw SFD and BMD for various types of beams. In the module 4, we'll talk about the bending stresses in beams, and in the module 5, we'll talk about the shear stresses in beams. And module 6 will cover slope and deflection of beams. And in the module 6 and in the module 7, we'll talk about the torsion, or we'll talk about the design of shaft, where we'll derive the torsion equation, we'll study the combination of shaft in series and parallel combination of shafts, and here we'll discuss about the in the module 8 we'll discuss about the cases where both torsion and bending acting simultaneously. And here we'll talk about the theories of failure for ductile and material, for ductile and brittle materials. So in the module 9, we'll talk about the we'll study about the columns, where we'll discuss about the Euler's theory of column, and we'll discuss the Rankine theory of columns. We'll discuss the various boundary conditions of columns. So this will be the whole syllabus in this subject, strength of material or solids and structures. So in the next lecture, we'll start our first module, where we'll talk about the simple stress and strain. Thank you.